also a snack bar out in the lobby that you're able to use. So for now, I'd like to hand it over to Professor Carmen. He's going to give you a little program of interview with some opening remarks, and we'll get this thing going. So thank you very much.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So welcome our students, parents, guests, and our viewer Excel Institute staff. It's a pleasure to have you all here. It's been a long journey. The 4 weeks that our students spent here is just a little piece of it. They've been actually preparing for it during the spring semester, going through our online course. We've been trying to put together a nice program for high school students throughout the United States. I'd like to give you a bit of an overview of what this program looks like, especially for our guests. Now our students are very familiar with it. And then I'll hand it to Bob Shin to kick off the event. Many of you know already, we have three courses that we've taught this during this BeWorks Summer Institute time. The first course is on grammar, so you can see that on the left. That course is really focusing on what one would call sort of a reflexive low level autonomy. How do you actually have a drone stay up in the air, look down from its cameras and understand where it is roughly, and try to make progress in a race, go through like these little loops and turn around in complicated environments. So on my right, we have another course that's teaching at a race car. We have a mini race car, and it's completely autonomous, just like the drone. And the race car goes through this racetrack. It can see the walls around it. It can see that brick yellow wall from its cameras. And there are many challenges that it's going through, for example, that ramp up and ramp down. And the car is able to understand all of that through the autonomous CC, its environment, and make a little bit higher level decisions to navigate through. And we have one more class called Cogworks. Their demos are just right outside if you wanted to check them out. And they're building these kinds of systems for how do you actually build like a cognitive system like one you would use at your home or on your phone to help you out with a number of tasks. All these classes actually form what we in academia call full stack autonomy. So these are things that in the future may enable a number of different kinds of products that may become a part of our daily lives. And if you look through into the industry, you can see these kinds of systems proliferating. For example, many of you are familiar, I'm pretty sure, with Google's autonomous car. Google is trying to build for a decade now this fully autonomous car. So you can imagine our race car, a small version of it. Many of you have heard that Amazon is building these drones to do delivery. So you can imagine our drone racing kind of challenge to be a small version of it. I don't know if you've heard, but Facebook is trying to build an airplane that can go around for days and provide internet in places that are not accessible. And so that's another piece of the UAV class. And all of these companies are actually working on nowadays, trying to build little home pods so you can put it on your home and you can, tell it to schedule something for you or turn on the lights, off the lights, adjust the heat, and so on. So the Cogworks class is doing things on this one. We at MIT teach a number of classes in this way, and this particular class is unique, just like our MIT classes, for a number of reasons. It's not because we just kind of teach autonomy and robotics and AI, but it's also because we teach it in teams. All of the people that are doing here work with teams, and also we teach it in a project-based manner. We don't give them a kind of a little schedule for them to follow, but rather we give them a project, and students here design a software system to be able to implement that, which is also key. So when you look at the world today, there's a lot of, for example, entrepreneurship kind of happening, and that is related to, so that's how we teach project-based, how we teach that through project-based learning. And also people interact a lot nowadays. Like my students, organized through Facebook, they use these programs like Slack or GitHub and so on. That's a way to interact and work in a team. So we actually teach students those kinds of things in the class. For example, there are lectures on collaboration, teamwork, and so on. And I'd like to quickly tell you that the classes that you're seeing here are actually modeled through some MIT classes that exist at MIT, in the MIT undergraduate curriculum even today. If you wanted to look at the MIT course catalog, you'll see, for example, a class called 1630, remember everything here. Called 1630 is called Feedback Control Systems. It's just like our drone course. It has a little bit more of the foundations, but the implementation is pretty much the same. There's another course called Robotic Science and Systems. It uses exactly the same platform that we have in the race car. Just very quickly, for example, Robotic Science and Systems uses a race car that has very advanced sensors on it, cameras, laser scanners, you'll see in the day. And we have the students race through the tunnel. So this is what the undergraduates do. If I can show a quick video. So this was from the time that we taught the class in 2016. So the students program a fully autonomous car that can navigate in the basements of MIT. The speeds are a little higher, but the complexity is much lower than compared to here. So what our students have accomplished in here is almost as hard as this one. That our undergraduate students, sort of juniors and seniors at MIT, do. And we have also classes that teach drones. Like, we actually have a class. We give every student a drone. They take it home. It's a very small version of the Parrot drone that you see here. And students would then do experiments and projects on these drones. For example, one of the projects was to do like a little line following. You would paint a line with it, and the drone would follow it. So this, what you're seeing here, is a slightly more complicated version of it on a bigger drone. In fact, one of the projects when I taught this course for my undergraduates at MIT for the first time, one of the projects took this big drone that you're seeing here and did a very simple version of what you're seeing here, kind of using these tasks for the drone to find where it is and be able to navigate to the next point. So our students here, our high school students, are doing a little advanced version of this. And I'd like to tell you that, you know, this is kind of a new pedagogy that we're trying. We're trying to build a program that we're hoping will be one of the best high school programs out there that's teaching of autonomy, robotics, AI, and beyond in the coming years. We're hoping to grow it to a large extent. We're hoping to make it online supported, an online course free for everyone to attend in the spring semester, and then some of the students, as much as we can afford, to bring them here and have them go through some of the projects so that they can do a lot more. I would like to say that these are not easy, so I'll show you some things from my high school class. So you start to look at these cars, and these kinds of things happen. In fact, you'll see some of the cars, for example, the drones go very fast, and you know, I'd like to let you know that as you increase the speeds, it gets even harder and fun to happen. This is again from my undergraduate course at MIT, using the same equipment. It's very tough. Our students work very hard, and you will see how well what they worked on are working. Please go around, explore. This is going to be an amazing program. I'd like to close with a few things. One is that this wouldn't have been possible with a huge amount of staff. So we have 100 students here. We have 50-plus people helping with the class. There's maybe 10, 20 core people who are spending more than full-time. Full-time, and by full-time, I mean 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. on this course. These are some of the people that I've shown who've kind of helped in the foundation, but also we have a lot of instructors. So I think the list of the instructors will go by for all of the three projects. And thank you so much to the staff who put in a lot of effort doing this kind of education program. Sponsors. Without the sponsors, this couldn't have been possible. Just to tell here to everyone, we have almost 100 students here, and the program is completely free. The students or the parents don't pay anything. We get to pay as much as we can, and that happens through our sponsors. So thanks to our sponsors as well. Program is through the Lincoln Laboratory and the MIT Beaverworks. So the Beaverworks is a joint venture between the School of Engineering and the MIT Lincoln Laboratory. And we have the director of Beaverworks here, Bob Shin, who's a close friend and also an amazing colleague who I've gotten a chance to work with for several years now. He has decades of engineering experience and leadership experience in this domain. So it's my pleasure to introduce Bob Shin to kick off the event and give you more information on Beaverworks.